Hi. In this video, I will solve a problem related to reflection coefficient, standing wave ratio, and input impedance of the line. Let us see this problem. A lossless transmission line with Z0 equal to 50 ohms given data, that is Z0 equal to what, 50 ohms, is 30 meter long, means the length of the line represented by L is 30 meters, operates at 2 megahertz, means frequency is 2 megahertz, or else it is 2 into 10 to the power 6 edges. The line is terminated with a load of load impedance ZL equal to what, 60 plus j 40 ohms. If U equal to U is given as what, 0.6 into C, where C is the speed of the light in vacuum, that is 0.6 into 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. Find gamma. We need to determine what gamma and standing wave ratio, S, and after that ZIN, input impedance of the light. Okay. First of all, we can find gamma like this, that is ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. It is a complex quantity. And what about ZL is given? 60 plus J40 minus Z0. Z0 is given as what? 50. Then here 60 plus J40 plus 50. Then the value of gamma, it implies gamma equal to 60 minus 50, that is 10, plus J40, and here 60 plus 50, that is 110 plus J40. Don't cancel like this. 10, 10, 40, 40. Okay. So this is 110 J40, 10 plus J40, and here 110 plus J40. And after simplification, you will get this one as value of that gamma is equal to 0.3523 at an angle of 56 degrees. At an angle of 56 degrees. This is the value of gamma. Next, go for what? S, calculation of standing wave ratio. S equal to what? 1 plus mod gamma. 1 minus mod gamma. So what is 1 plus mod gamma? 1 plus 0.3523. 1 minus 0.3523. And after simplification, you will get that S value as 2.088. S value as what? 2.088. No units for gamma and S. And last one, that is what? ZIN, calculation of ZIN. What is the formula for ZIN? For lossless line, it is a lossless line. We have the formula, that is Z0 into ZL plus JZ0 tan beta L by Z0 plus JZL tan beta L. Okay. In order to find this ZIN, we require what? Z0 is given, ZL is given. We require this beta L. Further, we need to determine what? Beta. We have U, phase velocity is nothing but what? Omega by beta. Then beta equal to what? Omega by U. Omega by U. What is omega? That is 2 pi F by U. U is given some value. So then it is what? 2 pi F is 2 into 10 to the power 6, 2 megahertz. U, that is velocity, 0.6 into 3 into 10 to the power 8. And after simplification, we will get this value as beta. Okay, let us go for that is beta. And next, beta L. And if you go for beta L, then this 2 pi into 2 into 10 to the power 6 by 0.6 into 3 into 10 to the power 8. into L. L is what? 30 meters. And after simplification, we will get this one as what? That is 2 pi by 3. This is into 30, 2 pi by 3, 0.6 into 10 to the power 8. 0.6 into 10 to the power 8. That can be written as what? 6 into 10 to the power 7. Okay. This is 3 here 10 times. So 10 to the power 7. This 10 to the power 8. That is 6 into, this can be written like this, that is 2 pi by 2 into 10 to the power 7. And this can be written as what? 6 into 10 to the power 7. So this 10 to the power 7, 10 to the power 7, here 3 times. Finally, we got this as 2 pi by 3. That is 120 degrees. 360 by 3, that gives 120 degrees. Now, let us substitute this beta L as 120 degrees. We will get ZIN. So this part, calculation of S is over, gamma is over. Let us move on to that calculation of ZIN. ZIN equal to what? Z naught is given as what? 50 ohms. ZL, that is 60 plus j 40. J into Z naught, that is what? 50 tan 120 degrees by Z naught. What is that Z naught? 50 plus J into ZL. What is ZL? 60 plus j 40 into tan 120. Tan 120 value is what? Minus root 3. Tan 120 value as a minus root 3. After simplification, we will get this ZIN as, in the complex form, it is 24.01 at an angle of 3.22 degrees, or else it is 23.97 plus J into 1.35 ohms. So this is the value of ZIN. So the calculation of gamma and S and ZIN is over for the given data. Okay. You need to remember this formula, that is S equal to 1 plus gamma, mod gamma by 1 minus mod gamma. So this part represents only magnitude. And the formula for calculation of gamma is gamma equal to ZL minus Z naught by ZL plus Z naught. And in order to calculate ZIN, we require this formula. Okay, after simplification, we got ZIN as what? 23.97 plus J 1.35 ohms, or else we can write like this also, 24.01, 3.22 degrees. Okay, this is all about calculation of gamma and S. Next, ZIN. From Z naught and ZL, of course, we have the velocity of the phase velocity on the light.